One of the popular topics of discussion on this channel is how to organize different aspects of your data. Today, we are focusing on points of interest, both local and long distance. This includes restaurants, attractions, museums, galleries, bars, nightclubs, and more. Let's say you're planning a future vacation. And for this example, let's just say that it's a group trip. When you're in the research phase of planning a trip, you tend to collect a giant list of all the different places that you want to visit once you get there. This can lead to a few common issues. The first problem is odds are everyone in your group has their own list of places that they want to visit stored in different methods. For example, one person may have that information stored in a note, another person may have it in a OneNote document. Another problem is once you get to your destination, you and everyone else in your party now needs to know how to get to those different places from wherever you are at that moment. And if people split up into smaller groups, well, let's just say this. Watch the whole video. Solution? Try using the new shared guides feature in Apple Maps. To create your own personal travel guide, go into the Apple Maps app and swipe up on the bottom menu. Then keep scrolling to the bottom and tap on where it says New Guide. You'll now want to start by creating a name for your list, and for this example, I'm going to use my old home of Provincetown, Massachusetts. If you want to add an image to pair with the guide, you can select one from your camera roll. And for this list, I'm going to tap on one of my favorite drone shots that I took while I lived there, and now tap Create at the top right. Now let's tap into the search bar and add a business. For this example, I'm going to add Arts Dune Tours, and no, they did not pay me to say that. To add a business to your guide, just tap on where it says Guides, and then save it into the corresponding list. One of the features I love about guides is how it works with restaurants. Here I can access all of the information I need, including photos, reviews, menus, contact information, and check this out. Let's switch to Palm Springs for a quick moment and navigate to Spencer's restaurant. Again, did not pay me to say that. I can even book a restaurant reservation right through Apple Maps. Now, to do this, there is a special feature that you will need to enable. I'll show you how to do that in just a moment. When I'm finished creating my guide, I can share it with everyone else by tapping on the share button, and then I can send it to them by text message, email, or AirDrop. Each person can then save the guide into their phones, and that way everyone has access to the same data. Now, one of the questions that I'm sure a lot of people are going to have on this topic is what happens if you send your guide to someone else and then they add or remove a business? The answer is once you share a guide with someone else, it's basically a totally separate document. If they make changes to it, it does not reflect on your phone. Now, I have to admit, there is one downside to the guides feature that I do need to acknowledge, and that is that it does not work well with Android users. So let's just hope if you have Android people in your party, that they all have an iPhone person with them. And if not, hey, don't worry. I'm sure they'll be found eventually. Okay, I've got five more. Wait, just came up with another one. I've got six more power tips to teach you. And trust me, I am saving the best for last. Power tip number one, I recommend that you change the sorting order to distance so that it displays businesses that are closest at the top. Power tip number two, it is very likely that when you get to your destination, your preferred method of transportation may change. If that is the case, then be sure to go into settings and scroll down and tap on maps. And as you can see here in this menu is where you can make adjustments to your transportation preferences. Power tip number three, from this same screen, I want you to keep scrolling almost to the bottom, and here you will find the ability to add integration with ride booking and restaurant booking apps. For this example, I'm going to enable Uber, and now let's switch back into the Maps app so that I can show you how to use this feature. Let's say I'm pulling up a business that I want to go to. All I have to do is tap on the car icon, and then here on the right, you will see an icon of a person holding their hand up. When I tap on that, it shows me all of the different rates for Uber. Power tip number five, and you're gonna love this one. In addition to using the guides feature for places that you plan to visit, it's also a great idea to use it for places that you have visited and enjoy in your local community. That way, if anyone ever comes to stay with you and asks the age-old question, where's good? This gives you the easiest way to send them that information. Before I show you my number one favorite travel trick, I want to take a quick moment to tell you about two other videos, one that recently came out and one that's currently in production. If you recently bought a new computer, or if you're planning to buy a new computer, be sure to check out my video that teaches you how to get a lifetime license to Microsoft Office 2021 for only $88. It's totally legit. Read the comments if you don't believe me. The other video that I want to tell you about that I'll hopefully have out in 2 weeks is a very thorough tutorial all about Apple Music. So if you're thinking about switching from another music service, like Spotify, I hope this tutorial will be insightful. Okay, announcement time is over. Let me teach you my number one favorite traveling trick. Anytime you go on vacation, what I recommend you do before you leave is go into the Find My app and share your location with everyone else in your party. Then have them do the same with you. It's also not a bad idea to add someone who's back home. That way, if anything, you know, happens, your loved ones can find you, or at least your phone. We miss Jerry terribly, but he had a 13 Pro Max with 2 terabytes of storage. We found that, so it's not a total loss. Let's go back to the example from the beginning. Let's say your group splits up into smaller groups and then decides to meet later at a central location. If someone's running late, all you have to do is launch the Find My app and you can see where they are. To share your location with the other people in your party, just go into the Find My app and tap on People at the bottom. Then tap on Share My Location at the top right. And finally, add in the names of the other people in your party. You can give someone access to your location either until the end of the day, for 24 hours, or indefinitely. In this example, I would recommend going with the indefinite option and then set a Siri reminder to stop sharing that location once you get home safe. Now, for those of you out there who are parents, I want to just bring up, this is a great thing to do with your kids. I know my parents would always tell me to call them whenever I got home from a trip, and by using this feature, you can automate that process. Keep in mind, if you would ever like to work with me one-on-one, you can sign up for a little tech therapy session by visiting my website at techtalkamerica.com, or you'll find a link in the video description. So whether you need help with organizing your photos, migrating your data to a new machine, or if you just want to get your questions answered, then be sure to book a future session. Thanks for watching, folks. I'll be back in 2 weeks with my new tutorial all about Apple Music, so be sure to stay tuned. Thanks for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit the thumbs up like button, leave me a little comment down below, and if you haven't already done so, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.